to the common ground. Here, we celebrate the power of music and food to bring Americans together. Filmed from historical barn on Cash Lane in Music City, each episode features one musical artist and a diverse gathering of eight of their fans. Everyone brings a dish to the table, and they talk about one of the issues of the day, face to face, with compassion replacing contempt, as they keep their hearts, ears, and minds attuned to the common ground. I'm Wu Fei, and these are eight of my fans. Sara, Eva, Joshua, Greta, Alex, Andrew, Kristen, and Jeremy. Tonight, we are focusing on immigration. Let's celebrate America's greatest diversity, diversity of thought, and shine a light on some common ground.
As we all sort of know and understand, this country was, you know, kind of built up and is, you know, great because of immigrants and what they've provided for from, you know, everything from startups and tech and going all the way back to music and everything else.
Right, I'm all for immigration because I am an immigrant. And I believe the smartest and the most driven people should be in this country because this country is founded on some ideas, some really appealing ideas. But I am against illegal immigration. And it's because I think it violates the rule of fairness and cutting the line of a lot of smart and driven people. I think one thing I don't understand is why we can't even say it's illegal. I mean, you have to say it's undocumented. I'm not saying they are people are not illegal, but the behavior is illegal. There is rule, there is principle. And that's something I'm confused. I'm open to listen to different views.
You need to be compassionate when you consider that if their lives were perfectly comfortable at home, they would not risk life and limb to with kids in tow sometimes, to make this treacherous journey through the desert with no guarantee they're gonna make it or not.
Well, there's a frustrating thing with also the concept of asylum, which I think if that system weren't also broken, then maybe I would feel differently on the matter. But like the US denies asylum to a lot of people very consistently from a lot of situations. Like it is so unbelievably impossible to get from like the southern border. Like getting up from Mexico or anywhere in Central South America is so difficult to do within that system because they're just mostly denied and detained. Like that's just kind of what happens. And like there's a similar situation with this, with Syria and a lot of stuff that happens in the vague idea of what the Middle East is, where, you know, they don't have 12 years to get in here when the country just says no, even though they, for all sense and purpose, should be granted asylum because of their situation. So I think my circular point there is just I feel like that system also needs to be fixed for me to have kind of different views on immigration, because I think the immediacy of needing to not be where you are for myself personally supersedes, you know, trying to do it the right way or whatever that means, I guess.
So what would a fixed system look like or begin to look like?
Not denying asylum to people who are war refugees.
Well, I mean, when you go back to, it was Eva, right? Mm-hmm. I'm going back to Eva's question about should borders be open. I think that, like, when I think of the tension, I think, with immigration is the tension I feel when I think about that question, because if I think of it as just a basic human right, should people have the right to live where they choose? And I want to say yes. But I also understand that my initial tendency would be the borders should just be open. If you want to come here, you should come here. You should get to choose where you live, because borders are artificial anyway. But I also see the other side that people say that, you know, can we do that? Like, what would happen if you had an open border?
Is it practical?
Is it practical? And I'd like to say it is, because, you know, this is a very rich country, we have a lot of resources, but you know that's the tension. I think that people feel that if we were to open the border, what would happen? What sort of disasters would we have?
That's where I kind of feel the whole debate is completely wrong-headed, because mm-hmm. I don't think there's enough immigration, illegal or legal, here. We need more people.
Absolutely.
Have you ever tried to get anything built in Nashville? there are not enough people here. I mean, I lived in China for 20 years before I came here, so maybe I'm slightly biased about population numbers, mm-hmm. but we don't actually have enough people here.
I think that's part of what the issue is now. It's not that we think immigration is bad, it's that there's a disagreement on what the measures should be. So you mentioned the merit system. Mm-hmm. How do you measure merit? Is it somebody who's coming in for their PhD, or is it a single mom who's coming in who's willing to work her fingers to the bone to take care of her kids?
Yes, that's a hard part. It cannot quantify. It cannot be all PhD and STEM.
Good question,
no.
Yeah.
It's going to be so boring. Sorry. Yeah, it is.
No, you're not wrong.
Don't take that wrong,
Andy. For that.
No, it's okay.
It's easy to do the division by political, but what I'm finding more is that there's division among who feels like they have the right to be in charge and who should just work and stay in their place. And that's the one that disturbs me the most.
This is special.
Hey! Happiness, yes.
Okay, but did you make it yourself, Faye, or did Mama help you?
Is it yes, Mama helped me for sure. Mama do.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the sweet sticky rice with the red bean paste in the middle, and with the dates that made the character happiness.
Happiness.
So we got to stick together and have some happiness.
It's a happy date.
Yes, it's a happy date. Yes. 因为是雨藏灯。